Hey guys, it's Griffin here, and today I'm going to be showing you how to turn an AVI YouTube banner and Twitter header into a full Revamp layout. So, if you don't know what a Revamp is, it's basically what I just said. It's an AVI, a header, and a YouTube banner, all compiled into one picture so you can see everything. And Revamps are generally, they look the same, like they're the same theme. Like, right here you can see they all look pretty much identical except they're, different layouts. So what you're gonna do first is you're gonna download my personal Revamp template from the description of this video, and this is what I use to turn all my AVI headers and YouTube banners into Revamps. So yeah, go download that. Then once you have it open in Photoshop, just open the AVI header and banner you want to use to turn into a Revamp layout, and then I already have a few random ones open, so just take the AVI first, drag it into the Revamp template, and then you're gonna put it up in the upper left corner, then just drag it so it fits the little bars, those four little bars up here for the AVI, and just drag it so it fits. Okay, that's good. Then click enter. Oh, and by the way, the way you'll know when everything's aligned with the green bars is when you see red bars. Like, as you can see, the bars are turning red as they get aligned with the guides. So yeah, so now we have the AVI on the Revamp. Now we're gonna go to the banner, and then if your banner has bars like this, as you can see there are black bars on the top and bottom, we're just gonna cut that out using the rectangular marquee tool. So click it, then just drag it over the actual banner, then right click, then layer via cut. So now we just have the banner part. So drag that onto the Revamp template, and this is gonna go at the bottom. So just drag it into the guides until you see the red bars. Okay, that's good. So now it's aligned at the bottom. Now we're gonna take our header and do the same thing, but we're gonna put it in like the upper right section, which is where the header goes. So just align it like so. Okay, that's good. So yeah, now that you have that, we're gonna add a backing so it's not black in the back. So we're gonna go to the layer for the banner, then we're gonna hold Alt, then just drag and make a duplicate of it, and then just let go, doesn't matter where you are with it, then just drag it to the back, or drag it so it's behind the text and everything else except the backing, and then we're gonna drag it so it fits the whole thing. So hold Shift and just drag. And there you go. Then press Control A on your keyboard, and then up here there are alignment tools. Click the middle, the one that centers it to the middle, and then click the one that centers it like to the middle again, but vertically. So then we have a backing, but it doesn't look too good right now. So what we're gonna do to make it look better is we're gonna go to Filter, then Blur, then Gaussian Blur. Then put it to about like maybe 20. That's fine. And then what we're gonna do is go down to Adjustments, click it, then Solid Color at the top, click that, and then put the color to black, and make sure it's right above the backing. Okay, now it's black again. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna turn the opacity down to about 70. Oh, that's good. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna add a little layer style to the AVI header and banner. So double click any one of them.
Hi, Griffin.
Hi. And then click drop shadow. Check drop shadow, then put the opacity to 100. Then size about 20. Yeah, that's good. Then just put the distance to 0. Now it has shadow on it. And now what we're going to do is copy this layer style to the others, the AVI and the banner. So just right click the header layer with the layer style, then do copy layer style, then select both of the others that you want to copy the layer style to, or paste the layer style to. Then, once you have them selected, right click, then paste layer style, and it'll give the other ones drop shadow too. And then the last thing we're going to do, or second to last actually, we're going to double click the, we're going to change the revamp for, we're going to put who it's actually for into it. So double click the text layer right there, and then we're going to just put whoever the revamp is for. I'm going to put 7 Sim Sanctuary, because that's who I made this for. Then just center it, Control A, center. And then it's kind of a long name, so it doesn't look too good, but chances are the one for yours will be a little shorter. And then the last thing we're going to do is we're going to add some magic bullet looks to the backing, or everything besides your AVI header and banner. So what we're going to do is select all of the layers behind your AVI header and banner, then merge them, Control E. And then what we're going to do is do Control A, rectangular marquee, and right click, then layer via cut. And then go back to your move tool, and then just delete what you cut out. Okay, so now we just have the backing by itself. So go to filter, magic bullet looks. I'm assuming most of you guys have magic bullet looks since I did a tutorial on it, but if you don't have it, just go watch my tutorial and I'll show you guys how to get it. So once you have magic bullet looks open, I'm just gonna do a clean start and show you guys what effects to add. The ones I like to add to the backing are pop. I always like to add pop. Pop 100, size 300. Just makes the colors look really nice. And then we're going to add some haze / flare. Put it to the lens section. And then change the color to like a red color. And then, yeah, that looks nice. Or also, if your theme is like a different color, just change it to whatever color. Like if your revamp is a blue theme, then just change the color to blue. But I'm gonna do red since it's a red theme revamp. And the last one we're gonna add is lens distortion. And then put the distortion to like -4 or 5. And it'll just kind of stretch it out a little bit, and it'll look really nice like this. So yeah, that's it for the magic bullet looks. Then click finished. And just wait for it to add the effects. Okay, so now you basically have your revamp. That's pretty much it. And also, if you have any questions about anything I did in the tutorial, or you don't know how to do something, just ask me on Twitter. And as always, I will have my social media information in the description for you to go ask me. And also, be sure to check out my Sellfy. It'll be in the description. I've been adding a lot of products to it, like banner PSDs and thumbnail templates and stuff like that. So if you want to design like me, then just go check that out. But that's it for today's tutorial. Be sure to leave a like and comment, and also subscribe. I'm almost at 1,000 subs, and I'm gonna do something huge for that. So yeah, that's it. I'm out. Peace.